would not have had an erection in a swimming pool with females.
No, no.
Oh, no, I've got to say that because that,
really
that is.
Like that.
No, well, it was. I mean.
I just couldn't have scratched it.
It's right, though. It's right. It's...
Oh, you didn't know that they think you're gay?
When was this? When did Derek try and tell you this?
This was
a while ago.
2 weeks ago.
What did he say? Tell us, shut up. What did he say?
He said, that boy is gay. I've got so many friends who have been closet gay, some of them married. He is so gay, blah, blah, blah. And he went on and on for hours about it.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
He says that around me as well before as well.
Mm. Has he? What did he say?
Know.
Same shit.
You hadn't had this part. You hadn't had this part.
When we were all sunbathing in the garden, he came to me. When you and Anthony were in the garden sunbathing, he goes, oh, I had to look twice. He said, I thought what a lovely, handsome gay couple.
Oh, man, the cheeky bastard. The cheeky bastard.
Anthony, mate, you've got to have to actually shag a girl on here now, just to fruit in front
you
of
what?
Everyone. Shag a girl in here.
What have I got to do? What have I got to do? Someone gets a painting lager.
You can't do anything.
But yeah.
The man's a gobshite.
He's got no feminine attributes at all. He doesn't speak camp, he doesn't act camp, he doesn't do camp things. How is he gay?
He
I think I might go outside and do some press ups, like. Because I'm not gay, you know?
2:15 pm. Craig and Orla are in the kitchen.
Do you think you were going last night?
What?
So you thought 1,000,000%.
No, I wanted to go. I was ready. I was.
Do you still want to?
Yeah. I'm not quitting.
Do you really not enjoy it in here?
No, I like. Do you know? I have enjoyed my time, but do you know whenever you've had enough? And I feel that I've had enough.
Right.
I just certain people, I just can't be around anymore in the house. That I just need to go. I hear people being false.
Most of the housemates are in the garden.
It's come to my attention that you think I'm gay.
No, I haven't said that.
Science just told us that you think I'm gay.
Well, you can speak for yourself, can't you?
Exactly, that's why I'm bringing it up. Do you think I'm gay?
I didn't think so, no.
You don't? Not today, anyway. Not today. No, it just came to my attention. I thought I can't let that be said because I don't want that said about us.
Is that what Craig said?
That's what science told us.
Now, what I mean,
he says he was in the closet.
What I mean is that Leslie used to say that, didn't she?
Leslie used to say it. Yeah.
And Craig.
Yeah.
Right.
But did you not see it?
I don't know whether you are or whether you're not. And actually, I couldn't care a damn.
But that's fair enough if you don't care. You know what I mean? It's just science told us that you said to him that.
Well, I don't now think you are anyway.
You don't think I am now.
No.
Cool. Because I'm
but
not.
Would it matter? Would it matter to you if people thought that you were?
A little bit.
Is it such a horrendous thing to be?
Not really. Yeah. It's just someone going on about it, saying, "I think he is." I can't really. Let that pass by. I kind of feel as if I've got to bring it up.
PM. Science and McCorsey are in the living room. Orla and Derek are in the bedroom.
You know, the thing about being here, really, is that none of it matters very much in the end.
Mm-hmm.
None of it. And it's particularly so for me, being so much older than anybody else here. And a lot of people are even kind of emotionally younger than their years as well. I mean, although I am much older, I mean, I sort of behave in a younger way.
Uh-huh. But it's your life experiences that make you...
Yeah. But I'm a serious person, really, at heart. It does get you. It really does.
Yeah, it does. It takes a lot of strength to deal with it.
I think it's going to get worse, though.
Oh, yeah.
All these jokes, you know, all these practical, these mind games and everything.
Yeah.
Anthony comes to the diary room.
Ask him for the flash spray as well.
Oh, shit, what was I going to ask? Oh, yeah, I know what I was going to ask. What? Woo! Yeah! What's this?
Something's happened. Dad needs to go in there. Spike. No, it's that little shit. That's going to be me.
I was about to go in there.
What happened? You bitch!
Congratulations. You are the 2000th diary room entrant.
Yes! Classic!
Anthony, what is it?
Anthony, please cut the ribbon.
Oh, Mint, where's the scissors at? Classic! Hey! Oh, man. Yes! Classic! I love, absolute love that.
Some of us have gone missing. That's Anthony.
Anthony and Ola have gone missing.
Anthony's
gone
in there.
Ola? Yes,
music
or something. Ola's still here. It's just Anthony.
Yeah, Anthony's gone in there.
I'm emotional.
Anthony, as you are the 2000th person to visit the diary room,
yes,
you have won a very, very special prize.
What is it?
Anthony, you've won a date with someone very special.
Who?
You have won a date with Big Brother.
Ah, Mint!
You are one lucky housemate.
It's not. I hope it's someone with a higher pitched voice than yours, though.
Big Brother will meet you in the diary room at 6 o'clock sharp, Anthony.
Class, have I got to get dolled up?
Big Brother advises you dress to impress, Anthony.
Right, seriously, I'm going for a serious workout. And then I'm gonna try and look sharp as possible, and I'll be here 6 o'clock.
PM. Anthony is preparing for his date with Big Brother. Mikosi and Craig are in the kitchen.
I wish we had loads of bananas next week. I think me and you should say to the shopping list again. I don't think anyone would probably object to that.
No.
And I think fucking bananas, I think we've not got to have to buy them, loads of them. Because that is the best dessert. And not that, do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Oh, fabulous.
Derek, Kamal and Orla are in the bedroom. Science is asking about cigarettes.
Where are they all gone?
They're all gone. Ah, you're not getting one.
So someone's jacked you like that, bang for rights.
Science,
why would I lie about that? I don't want my cigarettes to go. They're my fucking bargaining for cake. And
so
someone's actually gone in to cut
your cigarettes?
Yeah, definitely.
He says you've got one left. You've got one there, yeah? And that's for emergency.
No, just respect science, right, as well.
Shut up!
Don't talk to me!
Maxwell,
give
me a shot.
You didn't get on with you.
Me and me and him still used to, what are you talking about?
I told you already. You know what they used to
do? I don't care.
You will care.
No.
Yeah, you will.
No, I won't.
It's all right, though. You might think you've got the power now, but I feel that clip is up in you right now.
Please, science, I asked for quiet.
I feel sorry for his mother, I feel sorry for his mother.
Don't ever say that. I made the mistake in saying that.
What did you say?
I said I feel sorry for your mum, and he was like, don't.
Oh, yeah, he kicked off
big time. But I was pushing his nerve type thing, do you know?
I can push him so easily.
Oh, I know, yeah.
You mentioned.
Well, I can, you see, by just completely ignoring him, which drives him absolutely mad.
See, that's what happened today, because I was ignoring
him. If I just ignore him, he goes absolutely
dotted. He
hates being ignored.
He loves attention.
You know, like these little children that sort of become hysterical and they scream and scream and scream.
Yeah, it's like a 2-year-old.
It's exactly like that.
I told him that today. No problem.
The most extraordinary thing about him is always wanting to assume the role of leadership.
Yeah.
There are lots of people that think that leadership is shouting. you know, the way you become the leader, yeah. or people take notice of you is to